But first, Amnesty International has just issued a report documenting what it says is clear evidence that the Assad regime in Syria has been illegally imprisoning, torturing, and murdering political opponents. William Brangham has more and a warning. Some of the details here are disturbing.
Amnesty's report says that somewhere between 5 and 13,000 people were tortured and executed at one military prison outside Damascus between 2011 and 2015. Amnesty alleges that officials at the highest level of the Syrian government approved the killings, as did the Grand Mufti of Syria, the highest-ranking religious figure in the country. I'm joined now by Sunjeev Bery. He's Amnesty's director of advocacy for the Middle East and North Africa. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Very, very troubling reading in this report and the stories of the people who were tortured and executed at this prison. Can you tell me, who were these people?
There are thousands of civilians as well as some ex-military officers who are held at Sadnaya prison in Sadnaya in Syria. We estimate that between 10 and 20,000 people are held there now. And for years, on a weekly basis, as many as 50 people have been hanged in mass executions by the Syrian government at this prison.
And are these people who are picked up, what are the crimes that they're accused of?
Many of them are perceived to be opposition to the government, although, you know, when you're doing this kind of mass arrests, mass torture and mass execution, who knows what individual people's backgrounds are? And of course, peaceful, nonviolent opposition to a government is certainly not a crime. But with that background, many of them are subjected to forced confessions through extraordinarily brutal torture. And once that confession is put on via ink to paper, then the execution process begins.
I understand a lot of the documentation for this report came from people who've witnessed what's gone on in there. I understand that there is some kind of a trial process, a so-called trial. Yeah. Can you explain a little bit about what goes on?
Sure. And just to put it in perspective, the so-called trial is a total of 1 to 3 minutes.
So 1 to 3 minutes long.
1 to 3 minutes per person who is then later executed. So you have thousands of people in these prisons subjected to extraordinarily brutal torture in complete silence, living under rules of complete silence, routine deaths. A certain percentage of the population in this prison are then taken to trials via a military field court, a so-called court, in a suburb of Damascus, where during a 1 to 3 minute trial, with, of course, no lawyer present, no due process at all, in 60 to 180 seconds, they are sentenced to death. That death sentence is then rubber stamped by higher authorities up to the highest levels of government, and then later they are tortured and hung to death.
The thing that was so striking to me among many in this report was the bureaucracy, the documentation of it, the fingerprinting, the getting witnesses to sign that they had never been mistreated, getting doctors to certify that all these deaths occurred because of natural causes. Why do you think that the regime goes to these lengths to basically catalog their own war crimes?
It is difficult to know why the regime is so bureaucratically efficient in its documentation of its crimes against humanity. One possibility may be that the senior levels of the government, perhaps even including President Bashar al-Assad, want to know that the crimes against humanity that they are likely to be ordering are in fact being carried out by the military and intelligence bureaucracy. And so with each of these executions, the executions are signed either by the Grand Mufti, the highest appointed supposedly Muslim authority in Syria, although if you're, you know, signing off on all these mass executions, it's highly questionable what your personal morality is, or the Army Chief of Staff, or one other senior level defense official, the Minister of Defense.
What do you hope the international community does with this evidence?
Well, the first thing to do is to stare the evidence in the face and acknowledge what is happening. You know, it's time for Russia and China to drop their veto at the UN Security Council and allow the United Nations to take action on this. It's time for the U.S. government under President Trump to stop pretending that anything other than gross crimes against humanity are happening. And it's also time to acknowledge what Syrian refugees are fleeing. You know, you have perhaps 5 to 13,000 people killed at this prison, another 17,000 people killed at other prisons across Syria, and all of that against a backdrop of some 400,000 people who've died since the Syrian war began. You know, people are fleeing for their lives, and it is shameful that our own U.S. government here has said no to Syrian refugees at a time of such extraordinary suffering.
This report comes out amidst, it's just the latest piece of evidence on a mountain of evidence that already exists about Assad's regime, but As you well know, Assad still sits happily on his perch in Syria. I mean, do you think that this is going to move the needle in any way?
The needle definitely has to move, and one key factor is going to be putting pressure on the UN Security Council to take action. That means putting pressure on the Russian government, putting pressure on the Chinese government, and ensuring that the U.S. government, under the new U.S. ambassador to the United Nations, Nikki Haley, actually stands up on this issue and pushes on it, as opposed to referring to President Bashar al-Assad as some kind of ally in the so-called war against terrorism.
All right. Sunjeev Bery of Amnesty International, thank you very much.
Thank you.